Good morning, children. Welcome to your science class. So, children, as you know that now your term one is over. Okay. So, from today onwards, you are going to start the syllabus of term two. Okay, children. So, everyone, open your FusionSem textbook and the first third chapter of science, that is the world of animals. So, children, in this chapter, we are going to learn about the different type of animals and their uses. So, children, as you know, in the earlier time when there is no houses and people are not aware such of technique, so the animals and human beings both are lived together in the forest. But after some time, they moved towards the flat lands and they started build the houses and start the cultivation of foods. Then people realized that the animals are also very useful for them. In how many ways they can use their useful products such as milk, and they also eat as a chicken or a flesh or a rod or raw materials. And they also know that we can use the animals in the agricultural process, and we also use them as a means of transportation. So when they feel that the animals are very useful for them, then they start taming the animals. So the animals that they are taming are known as domestic animals. Okay, so we can also say that the animals which we see around us are known as domestic animals. So children, when we think about the domestic animals, the one thing also come in our mind that it means there are some more types of animals. Yes, correct. So children, we can broadly divide the all animals into two types. One type will be the domestic animals and second type will be the wild animals. Now, what is the meaning of domestic animals, or what is the meaning of wild animals? How we can say that they are different, and in how many ways they are different? So children, domestic animals are those animals which we see around us, or the animals which are tamed by the human beings are called as domestic animals. On the second hand, the wild animals are those type of animals which are live in forest and which are not tamed by the human beings. Okay, so in this chapter, we are going to learn the types of the animals and what are the uses of domestic animals. Okay, so how we can learn it? We can learn it with the help of slides, videos, etc. Okay, so everyone, let's start. Okay, so children, animals are very useful for us in various ways. Okay, so in how many ways the animals are useful? See, there are different type of animals which are live with us. So the first type of animals such as dog, cat, sheep, hen, and horse, yes, correct. Bullocks, yes. Birds, yes. And such as sparrow, crow, lion, yes. And tiger. After that, yes, so some animals that are raised in personalized environment called farms. It means the animals which are raised by in personalized environment means we make some type of environment for them for production of dairy products or such as egg or their flesh. Okay, so such type of environment are known as farms, and all the farm animals which are tamed by us are called as domestic animals. Okay, so why we tame the domestic animals? Because from domestic animals we get our food. For examples, from cow we get milk, from hen we get egg, and from fish we get the flesh. Okay, so children, we can also say that we divide the production, we divide the food products in the two types of sources, that is direct source and indirect source. Okay, direct source means the different types of meat and seafood that we eat, which comes directly from the animals, are called as the direct source of food. But the product that we get from the animals, such as egg, milk, butter, cream, they all are known as indirect source of animals. So the first indirect source of the cows or animals, that is milk. We also produce different type of products from milk, are called as dairy product, such as butter, ghee, etc. Now, second one is the egg, from an important source of our diet now, and we get egg from the hen, duck, peacock, etc. They all are the sources of egg and flesh. Okay, children, and we called it as a poultry farming. Now, second type of main important of animals is that we get the different type of products from them. For example, leather and clothes material and fur, etc. We get all the products from the animals. Okay, it means from buffalo we get the different type of leather, and from snake we also get the leather, and we use the skin of dead animals to forming the leather. We use a snake, crocodile, camel, buffalo, all their skin for forming the leather. Okay, and we can also get sheep from the, we get wool from the sheep hair. We can also use the fur of some animals for making the different type of clothes material. Now the next type is important product is bee. From the beehive we get honey and wax. From the wax we can make the candles, and the honey is the edible product. Okay, now third one is that from the silkworm we get the thread, and with these threads we make the clothes of silk material, whether it is a suit, sari, etc. Okay, now the next one, is that, children, we also use the some animals at the in the past time as the means of transportations. For example, oxen draw carts, and horse also used for drawing carts. So these are the some animals which are used as the means of transportation. Okay, now bullocks also used for the plowing. It means we use in the agriculture. Some domestic animal, elephant, used for the carry loads, and also used for the pull huge log of food. So these are the some useful uses of the animals. Now what are some more activity or some more important about the animals that we can also use as the pet? Why? Because we know that the dog is very faithful animals, so we keep them in our houses for safety, for the safety purpose of house now, and we also use the animal for recreation. Okay, children, so these are some more useful activities of the animal. So animals are very useful for us in various ways. So what's our duty? It's our duty that we also help them and take care of them. Okay. Now the most important use of the animals is that the dung of animals. Okay. The dung of some animals such as cow, goat, buffalo, horse, and camel. Okay, the dung of these animals are used as the fuel or manure. Yes, we collect them and form this from them natural gas, biogas, and these all gases are used for the for the production of more useful crops. The manure is used in the agricultural purpose, and we because of the manure the production of crops will be very good or will be very better because of the manure or fuel. Okay, so these are the some importance of the animals. Okay. So now, children, we can also learn. So now we can also learn the different type of animals and their uses. So children, come to the presentation. Okay. So we also learned that long ago people and animals lived freely in the forest, and after slowly they moved out to the forest and built some houses and grew plants, and they started the taming of the animals. Okay, now some useful products that we get from the animals are the milk. We get milk from cows, buffaloes, goats and camels. We from the honeybees we get the honey and waxes, and we use some animals such as oxen, camel. They used by the farmers for the ploughing the field. Okay, now we get the wool from the sheep and rabbit, camel. Some goats are used to make the warm clothes. Okay, and after that we get the silk from the silkworms. From the skin of dead animals is used to make leather, shoes, bags, belts and purses are some example of leather. And children, one more thing, we keep animals such as dogs, cats as their pet now, because dogs guard our homes and cat keep mice away. We also use the dungs of cow, horses and buffalo, goats for the manure and fuel. Okay, now so children, this is about the domestic animals. Now we'll come to the wild animals. So I already explained that the animals such as tiger, lion, deer, elephant, zebra and giraffe do not live among us. They live in forests, so that's why they are known as wild animals. Okay, so if you want to see the wild animals, how you are able to see them? Because it's not possible to go out in the jungle and see the wild animals, because this is not safe for us now, because wild animals are also very dangerous for us. Yes, so that's why we have the zoo. Zoo is a place where the all wild animals are kept together in very enclosed places from which we are able to see them. Okay, so in zoo we see every different type of animals, wild animals. Okay, some zoos are in different size, some are very big and some are very small. Okay, and sometimes zoos has all different type of animals. Okay, and they're open for all. Okay children, so from today, we learn about the domestic animals, wild animals. So children, what you have to do, everyone, it's your assignment for you that you have to write the 10 numbers of domestic animals and 10 examples of wild animals. Okay, so everyone write it. So in the next video, I'll complete the chapter and then we come to the exercise. And there is one more assignment for you. Everyone write the hard words. Okay, write the hard words from the chapter, the word of the animals in your notebook. Okay, till then keep read the all chapters, complete the assignment. Okay children, till then stay safe, stay healthy. Bye bye.